Hey guys, this is Prashant. Today I'm going to talk about how to use your subconscious mind. Before telling you all how to use the subconscious mind, I would like to give a short intro about the two minds that we have in our brain. One is the objective or conscious mind, and the other is the subjective or the subconscious mind. The conscious mind is the one which is called as a reasoning mind. This is the mind which helps us to make decisions in our life, and the subconscious mind, its functions are: when we are sleeping, it keeps our heart functioning automatically, all the digesting process, circulations, a breathing process, everything has been taken care of by the subconscious mind. The subconscious mind doesn't argue with us, it just accepts whatever we believe it as true in our conscious mind. It just accepts it and starts working on it. Jim Rohn once said that stand guard at the door of your mind every single day. For example, you're going to a restaurant with your friend, and at that time your friend accidentally pours some sugar into your coffee. What will happen? Nothing, right? Just the sweetness of the coffee increases. At the same time, if your friend accidentally pours some poison into your coffee, means what will happen? You'll be dead, right? The same thing is for our minds. Our mind is like a garden, and we are the gardeners. So we need to be careful about the thoughts which we think, books which we read, and the people to whom we talk to. If all the things which we think, read and talk are good, the outcome will be good. But if we think bad stuffs, talk bad words to bad people, outcome will be the same, will be bad people. So we got to take care of our mind. We need to stand guard every day, just like Jim Rohn said. Our subconscious mind doesn't know whether it is good or bad. It just accepts the orders from the conscious mind and starts working on it. Your conscious mind is like a captain of the ship. A conscious mind is the one which directs a life, and a subconscious mind is like the A subconscious mind is like the people working in the engine rooms. It just accepts the orders from the conscious mind and starts working. Do you all know one thing, that anyone can make you look sad or depressed by just if anyone comes to you and says that, today why you are looking sad and depressed and dull? What happened to you? If they ask like this, means if your conscious mind accepts it as true and believe it, your subconscious mind will receive those orders from the conscious mind, and it will make you appear sad or depressed to the outside world. The same thing, if anyone comes to you and comes to you and say these same words to you, if you have the self-confidence with you, and if anyone comes to you and said, why you're looking sad or depressed, it's in the way we take it. If we have the self-confidence about how we look and know more about ourselves, no one's suggestion can make an impact on us. If we believe it as true and take it, our subconscious mind will receive it and it starts working on it. So that's the thing. So you got to take care of your subconscious mind. Stand guard at your mind, as Jim Rohn said, so that your outcome will be the good. Think good and be good. In computer they used to say something, garbage in, garbage out, like that. Good in, good out. So that's it. Use your subconscious mind in the right way and lead a happy life. That's it, done.